Welcome to another edition of We Love Rare Grooves, coming from the studios of Los Angeles, California. And I'm here with the team, starting off with the lovely Shantanay Irie, co-host.
Hello.
Welcome. How you doing, my dear?
I'm doing wonderful. How are you?
We missed you last week.
I know.
Out there making money for the team, right?
Trying.
All right. Keep that singing career going there. And joining us tonight is our consultant of the show, Mr. Robert A.
Mr. Music Magic, myself.
Man, you've been working hard there.
If you don't think I'm wonderful, ask me.
And then we got the producer extraordinaire, Mr. Greg New York Sneed.
Yes, sir. Brooklyn's in the house.
Brooklyn's in the house, baby. How you doing?
I'm from afar from downtown.
Ah.
Give a little mic level, but we'll get it fixed up.
And then we have the world famous DJ DeVoe. You the man.
Hey, good evening. How you doing? Happy Monday.
Happy Monday, man. We got a beautiful Monday here today.
Yes, yes.
Los Angeles, and we got a beautiful show getting ready to happen with, man, you're talking about legendary.
Yeah.
Can you imagine this young lady that we have on the show tonight?
Uh-oh.
Can you imagine if someone called you for, the word was called Supreme, and said, we want you to be a part of this legendary group. And you said, me? Yes, you.
Yes.
And we have one of the Supremes, I won't say the last Supreme, but the Supremes of choices, Miss Susaye Greene here. And her career spanned from the Ray Charles with the Raylettes, Stevie Wonder with Wonder Love. She has co-produced, written songs, and was lead on several groups. And tonight, as we do on We Love Rare Grooves, we're going to welcome this lovely and talented songwriter and singer, Miss Susaye Greene.
Hey.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thanks for having me.
No, thank you for honoring our studios tonight with all this legendary history and the things that you have done in your career that people just would be so surprised about, you know? I mean, your career started, what, when you were a young tyke?
Just a baby, that's
right. Doing commercials.
Sure, in New York City. Grew up in New York and did all kinds of commercials, bread commercials and all kinds of stuff.
Like baby food. Didn't we talk
Absolutely.
About Gerber's? And you
yes,
did.
Yes, we did.
And Carnation Milk.
That's right.
Wow, and that career span. So we are so welcome tonight, and we're going to play some songs because it's all about the music and the conversations on We Love Rare Grooves. And Greg, take us away of where the show, our listener audience can hear us and call in.
Well, you want us to give us a call at area code 323-965-1600. We're streaming live on rmconair.com. 323-965-1600.
And you want to call up tonight because we got, we got a superstar.
Yes.
Superstar.
Yes.
And I am the last Supreme.
The last Supreme. I said
right.
that, not the only, but the last Supreme.
Yes,
man,
indeed.
Hey, that's a great tribute to have to care to a lifetime. So as we do here on We Love Rare Grooves,
yeah.
we go deep down in the vault.
How deep?
We go real deep, like grave digger deep. Isn't that right, Chris, our young whippersnapper? You got the vault open for us tonight? And folks is going to be surprised on some of the songs that
I hope
sang.
So. I hope
yeah,
so.
Yeah.
You might as well, before we go on to the song, what's playing in the background? Go ahead, tell them about it. Why are we playing this tonight? Interluding all night long.
I can't hear it.
Oh.
The headphones.
And what we have playing right now is Michael Jackson.
Ah, yes.
I can't help it.
Thank you. I can't help it. I wrote with Stevie Wonder when I was in Wonderlove.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a very special song to us because, you know, songwriters write a song from an inspiration, from a point where you meet.
Mm-hmm.
He did most of the music and I wrote the lyrics. And it was just an inspired moment. And we knew that we wanted Michael to do it immediately. But it was only when we found out that he was actually going to do it,
mm-hmm.
and it had been presented to him, that we jumped around like three-year-olds, you know. We were
Man.
So excited.
Can you imagine?
So excited.
That had to be a wonderful... Mike Jackson going to
yeah.
sing a song you wrote.
Sure.
That's utopia.
Stunning. Right,
that's
exactly.
That's utopia.
Exactly.
You can't get any better than that.
No, I don't think you can as a songwriter.
Okay.
You know, he made such an impact. We can all remember the little boy, Michael,
mm-hmm.
coming out and... You know, singing like James Brown
mm-hmm.
when he auditioned for Berry Gordy. But who knew that he'd become the king of pop and one of the most inspirational artists of our time and of any time, really.
Wow. That's what we do on We Love Rare Grooves, mm-hmm. right, ladies and gentlemen?
Absolutely.
That's right.
This is our version of what, team?
Unsang.
Well, as we continue the show, we're going to go ahead and bring back a little... remembrance to you right now as we start the
Thank
show
you.
Here. If you look up there, our engineer, if he's ready, and DJ DeVoe.
Yep.
Y'all ready to take us away?
We're good.
Johnny's, let's do this with Miss Susaye Greene.
We'd like to introduce to you right now our newest sister to the Supremes.
Hier stellt Mary Wilson, die neben Sherry Payne neu Susaye zu der Gruppe gekommene Susaye Greene als Solistin vor.
I'd like to sing a song for you about love, universal love. Who knows where, but I
I'm a woman.
man. Go ahead, Greg was singing tonight. You know.
Oh, I know that song.
You know that song hit a note. Man.
I got the original vinyl of that, too.
Man, that's what we got, the original vinyl. We got some original vinyl in the studio tonight for you, my dear.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Yes, we do. We got some original so I can clean some seeds off tonight. Wow. Boy, we're going to have a good time.
What a treat.
See, I got a friend of mine. See, they all look at me, but see, you know where I'm coming from. Thank you very much.
Chris.
Chris is going to show the album there. So,
Yes.
My team here, they got a whole bunch of questions, but I'm going to just let you talk about the songs that we just played and let you handle that and tell us a little history about that. So we started off with the video.
Yes. The song, that song was recorded in Montreux, Switzerland, and we had been invited over there. It was the first year with the Supremes for me. We were on the road 11 months. I'll never forget it. But it was a song that Gene Terrell, who replaced Diana Ross, had done with the group. And they were kind of looking for things for me to showcase, you know, leads. Sherry had done a lot of the leads, and Mary was singing some things. And they happened to have the music. So they had this huge, fabulous arrangement. I said, I'll do that. I'll try that. I'd never sung it before. But I always got a standing ovation from it.
I see.
So I'm very proud of it, and I still do it. It's a heck of a song written by Buffy St. Marie.
Buffy St. Marie?
That's right, that's right. Of course, she had her own version of it, and it's been recorded by a lot of people. But the thing about the next song, the I'm Gonna Let My Heart Do the Walking, was that was the last top 40 charting song for the Supremes. This version was on the big silver package that they did called Let Yourself Go, which was the last three Supremes albums, plus a lot of bonuses, a lot of photos that hadn't been seen. And the fans lobbied for that CD and for those albums to come out. They'd never been on CD before. So we were very, very proud to get that package.
Wow.
And that was really a fabulous looking package. $75.
Can we still get one of those
packages?
You sure
can. Okay. You sure can.
We'll talk about it. All right. See how we can get one of those packages for the show.
But that was a great song. The Hollands, we got the Hollands involved once again, who, of course, along with Lamont Dozier, had such a huge amount of hit after hit after hit after hit.
Incredible.
Amen. You know, just history, Motown history. So we were very glad to get them back. I know Mary was very pleased. I had come, of course, from Wonderlove into the Supremes.
Okay.
So it was shocking in a lot of ways for me, you know. And Wonderlove was basically a band of some of the best musicians in the world. Greg Fillinganes, who went on to become Michael Jackson's music director. Michael Cimbello from Flashdance. Remember Flashdance?
Right.
The Maniac.
Right.
Michael Cimbello was lead guitarist, along with Ben Bridges. Raymond Pounds was the drummer.
Was Gil Strap with you guys?
No. He had been before.
Okay.
With the group just before me.
Sure. Okay.
But it was Denise Williams, Shirley Brewer, and myself. Wow. And what a group. I always said that was my band. You know? Well, that's what Stevie would say, because he was, you know, always in love and doing his thing. And left all. We rehearsed 6 days a week. And they were my band. I raised those children.
Okay, I see it.
Nate Watts, bass player, still with Stevie.
Yeah.
What a group. Oh, my God. They could play any kind of music, from jazz, all rock and roll, R&B, pop music, whatever there was that was going. And we wrote all these songs. We wrote Free while I was in Wonderlove with Denise, Nate Watts, and Hank Redd, who's the saxophonist.
Okay.
But talk about that new Bird song. Talk about
that. Until it's time for you to go.
Hey.
Well, until it's time for you to go, Harvey Fuqua, who had been one of the founding producers, along with Smokey and Mickey Stevenson at Motown, had married Barry's sister, and he and Johnny Bristol and Marvin Gaye were all married to Barry's sisters, and They were great producers, just tremendous fellows, tremendously talented, all of them. Harvey started his own company after he left Motown. But at this time, he was producing The New Birth, who were a tremendous group. They were greatly popular, and they were a hot funk group. You know, they could play a lot of different kinds of stuff. This song I had heard, Until It's Time for You to Go, because it was Buffy St. Marie's song. And it was just an interesting type of song for me. You mentioned Frankie Crocker.
Right.
Now, Frankie Crocker, of course, I grew up in New York.
Right.
And Frankie was the DJ of
Brooklyn
mine.
Over here.
Amen. Well, Queens over here, hey!
That New
and,
York.
That's right, that's right. The music was just tremendous of that time.
So we had a little story offline, as we do here on We Love Grooves. I find that little information out. So Frankie wanted to take you out on a... We'll want to take you to the
Frankie's
prom.
Frankie's going to take me to the prom.
He's about 80 years old.
I know, but, you know, that would have made my year. I would have been straight, reputation-wise.
That's true. If Frankie Crocker would have took you to the prom, that would have made a whole lot of stories.
It sure would.
I don't know about your reputation.
Well, he was the hottest DJ.
Yes, he was.
In New York at the time. And my friends were like, oh, you know, Frankie Crocker. But my mother said, no way.
So like any good mother.
Right.
Thank you, Miss Greene, Miss Vivian Greene.
She wasn't having it.
She was not having that.
She wasn't having
But Frankie remained a friend through the years and all the way up until his death. He played at 7 o'clock every day. He would play Until It's Time for You to Go and I Am Telling You.
Okay.
And he would discuss the voices of that fabulous lady and myself. So I was very, very proud of that song. You know, I sang the lead, I went in and sang it, and it was a bit disheartening to sit and watch American Bandstand, and there's The New Birth, and it wasn't me, but it was my voice.
Wow.
So that was a story, one of the stories that I told during the 20 Feet from Stardom film, which won the Academy Award, of course, for the best feature documentary. I was very, very glad to have been involved in that.
Awesome.
But that's just the circle, you know.
Yeah.
And how long ago did you do that project?
20 Feet we did in, where are we, 15? Mm-hmm. 2 years ago.
2 years ago? Okay.
Yeah, 2012 is when they started. And I was one, along with Mabel John.
Right.
We were one of the first people that they interviewed. We talked for 3 hours. My interview was 3 hours long, and I was probably in the movie that long, you know. But the impact of that film was, I think, so tremendous because everybody's a team player in one way or another. You know, everybody's 20 feet from start. There is no great project that doesn't have the people that support it. Mm-hmm. So when Gil Friesen, who was the who conceived the idea of doing 20 Feet, when he spoke to me, it was under the auspices of, we're doing a film about background singers. And I was really doubtful. I'm like, I just don't see it.
Right.
But, you know, I've been taught that if you get an opportunity that, you know, it makes sense in the long run to give props to the background singers, the great background singers that support all these records, all these tremendous records that really made these records. Yeah. And some of these ladies and gentlemen have had tremendous careers, you know, as background singers. I did a lot of backgrounds in L.A. with Quincy Jones, with all kinds of people. You know, you go
the
in.
Ray Letts.
Oh, yes. That's true.
Yes.
That's very true.
It's, you know, it's time for your book.
As well.
It's time for your book.
Working on it.
And the consultant is here for you.
Absolutely.
Well, I certainly will consult you. We need that history. You know?
No, and there's a tremendous amount of stories that go along with all the songs. That's what the Magic Fun song really is. That they just go there. And then the movie went deeper, and your book can even go all the way to the bottom.
Yes, I've had a very rich life, a very blessed life from childhood. You know, my main inspiration was my mother, who coached me. Vivian Greene was her name, and she got a lot of people ready for their careers. The Jackson kids, Janet, she got Janet ready to record, and that's how I got to meet all of them. You know, we lived right down the street from them in Encino at the time, And you'd see Michael walking down the street with a llama, you know.
So what would you say, moving from Houston, which I believe is where you were born, to New York at such a young age, what was that journey like for you?
Well, I've always known what I was going to do. I have always been passionate. I stood in the crib and sang. You know, when I'd sing myself to sleep, I would sing and rock, you know. But I always knew that that's my career. That was my passion, mm-hmm. along with the art. You know, I could paint, and my mother knew how to make me better. That was her talent. She knew how to make me dig deep, how to select a song and live with it and make it my own, which was just a tremendous blessing, you know, to have someone. My mother was from Nacogdoches, Texas, but she'd been a child prodigy. She was a classical pianist at 3 years old. So the destiny, you know, of that cycle, of passing all of that knowledge along. And you remember Webster?
Yes.
She taught Webster. She taught music, taught him music. And she, as I say, she got a lot of people ready for their careers. She was just tremendous in being able to see what your talent was and how to make you be your best. Mm-hmm. You know,
so what would you say, besides your mother, what other musical influence did you have?
Well, you know, there's a whole world of music out there. I mean, mm-hmm. I was influenced by Aretha, as most singers have been, mm-hmm. by the Motown. When I was a teenager, Motown came together and presented another whole side of music for us. But I would say Tony Bennett was a tremendous influence. Mm-hmm. Taught me how to phrase.
Yes.
Johnny Mathis, for that matter. I was always influenced greatly by male singers because mm-hmm. they could have a smoothness in their voice or a gruffness in their voice. Their phrasing was a little bit harder edged. And I learned how to attack a song and how to bring a song apart and put it back together through most of the male singers. Right. Ray Charles, of course, I wasn't allowed to listen to Ray.
He was banned from a lot of houses.
He was banned, yeah. But, you know, fate once again mm-hmm. happened. And I wound up as, you know, a tremendous friend of Ray's until he died. You know, he was one of the most inspirational people because what you saw on stage or what you saw in real life, that was Ray, mm-hmm. you know. And he did his thing. He loved music. He would have done it for free. Of course, he said, don't tell anybody about that until I'm gone. So that's the way, you know. But many, many people influenced me. Ella Fitzgerald, you know, all of the great classic jazz artists. Mm-hmm. Right. And then...
Don't blow it for your top five. It's in now.
Don't you worry. You hold them up. Now. But, you know, music is the kind of thing that, regardless of where we live, regardless of what kind of music we love, it touches the soul and it touches the humanity mm-hmm. in us. It's that place that we all meet. That's why a song, you can be singing in English, you can be singing in Japanese, but the feeling,
right.
you know,
right.
that's the human part of it. Mm-hmm. You know?
It was funny, we had a group on last week and they went over to Japan and I asked mm-hmm. them a question. I said, you guys don't even have a hit, the pyramids, but you're over there playing music and they don't even understand what you're saying. But like they said, they was grooving to it.
Amen.
And it felt the soul.
That's what it's about.
So please, give us a call where, Greg?
323-965-1600.
That's right. Streaming live on...
Ustream.
That's right.
Ustream.
And we're on rmconair.com. Hey. So call.
Hey.
Speak to our lovely guests here as you get, again, as we do it only on here, a groove lesson.
That's right.
A groove lesson.
At the groove yard. At the groove yard. That's what we do.
Well, we're going to continue as we do, getting into the music. And the conversation is such a great conversation. Thank you so much again.
Thank you.
Then we're going to continue. And we're going to come back and talk about some of the things that's going on now. Just tremendous what you have going on. But as our DJ DeVoe, world famous DJ DeVoe.
World famous.
Take us away.
For love.
that. Keep her going. Right. I see you, Susaye. You over there moving, jamming a little bit here on We Love Red Grooves. Hey, I want to thank our audience, our listening audience all over the globe. Isn't that right, ladies and gentlemen? We're all over the globe here.
Past the hemisphere.
We passed the hemisphere. We're in the globe. They're hearing from you in 71 different countries. May pick you up and say hello. Never know.
Well, hello, everybody out there. Love that.
Okay. So we had, we came in with some great music again. You were giving us the history on how it is to be free. What was that?
Yes, Free. Free was written when I was in Wonderlove. The way that Denise tells it is that Nate started it off with the bass, and Hank Red, who was the band leader at the time and the saxophone player, came in, and the guys started this great little groove. And it was actually more, it was more Brazilian in feel than R&B, than the way that it wound up. But Denise sang, whispering in his ear, my magic potion of love, and I just want to be free. And she says that I just scribbling away and walked up to her and said, sing these lyrics, sing this. And that's how Free came about.
Okay.
And it was just natural. I mean, when a song is like that and it just lays and the lyrics fit, you pick them out of the universe and they just fall in the pocket, and the groove was there, and everybody knew that that was a special song, a special moment. So I've had so many people tell me, this made a difference in my life, or this song carried me through. That's what makes a songwriter live.
Wow.
That's it. That's it for a songwriter, you know?
Okay.
Because when you're writing that song, you're not thinking about, is it going to make the charts? Is it going to be this? But when people come back to you years and years later and say, that's my jam, and stuff like that, you know, hey, there's nothing better.
What else do you have for us, Shantanu?
Now, how did you get involved with Ray Charles and Stevie Wonder? How did those
With Ray Charles, Dee Irvin, who sang a song called Do You Would You Like to Swing on a Star? Was running Racer Music, which was Ray Charles' publishing company.
Right.
He was a friend of my mom's. And he called her. We hadn't been in L.A. very long. And said, would you be interested in bringing her up to sing for Ray? So I went up there and I sang. I brought my charts and sang a song. And I went to work for him that night.
Do you remember what song you sang?
I think I sang My Funny Valentine and Unchained Melody, something like that.
Must have put it down. Next thing you know, come on and be a Ray.
Amen.
Come on.
And he actually hired me as a soloist. So
Ray
always
Charles
had a,
did?
Oh, yes.
Did he feel your wrist?
He's so out of
you
order.
You know you're wrong.
He's so out of order.
But it's all right.
He's out of wrist. He was like, come
it's
on,
all right.
Ray, that's not my wrist.
There's none of that. My mother was there.
Ray did it like Ray
okay,
kid.
Okay.
You had to go on the road with Ray.
That's very true. But I'll tell you the truth. You know, Ray Charles was a very special person, a very unique artist whom we know changed popular music.
Of course.
And there was no one like him. There never will be. And I'm not ashamed to say that he was one of the dearest friends I ever had.
Aww. That's my
he taught
man.
Me, yeah, he taught me quite a lot.
That's my man.
The commitment to a song. You know, he sang Georgia. He sang the songs that were his songs every night.
And he couldn't see, and he kept his masters. That's my man right there.
Okay.
Right.
History.
Right, what's everybody
that
else's
makes a
excuse?
Difference. That's right. That's right.
So what is the highlight of your career?
Oh,
out of all
goodness.
The years, what would you say is the one you'll probably never, ever, ever?
I don't know. I'm an optimist. I'm
right
a
here, right now.
Who,
right.
Amen.
This is
that's it.
I love
that. You know, I'm about what's next. And what. I just, for instance, I just did, Spike Lee is doing the documentary for Off the Wall. This is a 35-year anniversary.
Really?
For Michael?
Yeah.
I feel so old. Oh, my God.
You know, we watched him grow, you know. But to
my
go,
afro was
to
bigger
go,
than Mike's.
Oh, God.
Yeah, but probably not as cool. He had the best natural, you know. But
my afro was better.
Michael Michael was such a special artist. Mm-hmm. And when they asked me, they called and asked if I'd be interested in doing, you know, run right on over. Stevie Wonder and I wrote that song. And it just is a special moment to see it this far down the line.
Yeah.
That, you know, they did the Bad. Mm-hmm. They did a documentary on Bad. But Off the Wall, I don't think I'm out of line in saying that by far it was one of Michael's finest moments.
Yes. It was, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
You know, and even now, I think, and in the future, people will realize that it was a real watershed moment for his talent.
That's when they call him Mike.
Yeah. There you go.
Susaye,
do
you know how many people have sampled this song?
Oh, yes.
From R&B acts to hip-hop acts?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Would you say thank you as you go on?
Thank you very much. What can I say? You know, in the beginning of sampling, I think a lot of writers, a lot of artists were very confused, were very frightened about what is this going to be? But I Can't Help It and Free raised my child.
Yes.
You know, bought them big shoes and them big feet.
When them checks were coming in, and say, yeah, I'm okay with this.
Come on.
Sample away.
And it's a new generation of people who appreciate.
Yeah, you go.
I have had nothing but love from the hip-hop generation. Mm-hmm. From hip-hop generally. Chuck D said to me that when Partners came out, Partners was the album that Sherry and I did after the Supremes. He was a DJ in New York at the time. He said, we played Partners, and the fact that two women did such an intelligent project that produced, they produced along with Gene McDaniels. And
100 pounds of clay.
There you go. You know, you can't fight that kind of legacy of music.
Right, that's right.
We always do this on the show. Is there anybody, I know you're in the here now, but is there anybody that you have not performed with yet that you would love to perform with?
Absolutely. There's a South Korean artist named Rain B. Now, we talked about how music, regardless of language, well, I don't speak Korean, but this is a soulful child. And he's got the kind of vision, because Michael Jackson was his hero. Mm-hmm. So he's a dance artist, he's an actor, he did Ninja Assassin. Remember the movie Ninja Assassin? Mm-hmm. He was the first Korean to star in a film, in an American film.
He can sing too?
He can sing his...
Because I seen him do Kung Fu.
What's his name again?
His name is Rain. They call him Rain.
Can you do your research, producer extraordinaire, and see what
so
we come up
with? Make it rain.
We're putting it out there. Hey,
gang, we got a caller. Sure. We got like the lines are lighting up.
Lit up.
Lord have mercy.
You know what?
Pittsburgh school system. Jesus.
But he's my favorite young artist. I mean,
Thank
there are a
you
lot of young
that.
Artists that are just wonderful now, even though a lot of popular music gets a bad rap, you know? But there are people out there making good music who have high standards, who want to be innovative, who want to make a difference.
Like me.
Let's take this caller, young whippersnapper. We have a caller on the line. Caller, welcome to We Love Rare Grooves. Who's on the line?
This is Carl Jenkins.
Carl, welcome.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi. Susaye, I am a friend of yours on Facebook. You may remember me as CJ Jenkins.
Of course I remember you. Okay. Of course I do. It's lovely to hear from you.
Oh, it was a blessing to hear from you, too. And I just really needed to let you know that I was so blessed to find you and Sherry connecting again and being able to do the things that you do. Just watching that being done is just like another blessing in my life, just to watch you guys do that.
How kind. And, I love you.
And I really do hope something comes of that as well.
Well, I don't hear you any longer, but I just need to let you know that we are doing our Supreme Partners shows. We've done the second one, and we're just having the best time, you know.
Yes.
The fact that the fans lobbied for Partners means a tremendous amount to us. We were able to do, there were no other women producing and writing and singing their own music like that, you know.
Right.
There was Tina Marie, but we were doing a different thing, and we're very, very proud of Partners, of that album. It was released, it's still available, and you can find it online, and we're very, very proud of it. So I appreciate you saying it and for reaching out. You know I love you.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, caller, for that. Continue to listen to We Love Rare Grooves. Have a great evening. As we continue on with the show, ladies and gentlemen, we're having just such a fabulous time here, wouldn't you say? The consultant over there, DJ DeVoe, Greg, what's going on?
Marvelous.
Marvelous. Thank you very much. So as we do, we have our upcoming event from one of our guests that we wanted to make sure that people would still be going to there. And I did not send that over to you.
Nope.
No, I did not. So that's going on May 8th. Did you have information for us, Chris? Thank you very much.
Why don't we do a little shout out to my mailbox? If we got that, and then you can
come back.
Send me off the information, and we'll put it out there.
Where do you go in the community for live scan, fingerprinting, notaries, faxing, printing, and mailing needs? My Mailbox at 3651 South La Brea at Rodeo. My Mailbox has been a part of the community since 1997. We are a family-owned and operated business specializing in postal services as well as many other business services. Stop by today to mail, fax, scan, or print your important documents. They offer live scan and notary services to all clients and a host of other services that can be found in most FedEx and UPS stores without the hassle of the long lines. Come see why their clients keep coming back to My Mailbox and call them home. They are located at 3651 South La Brea at Rodeo. Feel free to call them at 323-296-5396. That's 323-296-5396. Or check them out on the web, mymailboxla.com. That's mymailboxla.com. Stop by today.
All right. And don't forget to give us a call at 323-965-1600. That's 323-965-1600.
Hunt it.
That's Brooklyn talking.
That's my Brooklyn, yeah. And we're streaming on rmconair.com. And then check out our replay on YouTube under We Love LUVV Rare Grooves.
Take us away, Johnny.
Always in the
no one else I've ever loved before. There's a certain something in my heart. For the first time in my life, I know for sure. Settled differences is where we stand. With a little effort, we can work those out. I just wanna hold you in my arms again. Oh, can you find the heart to let me in?
Accept the obligation. Whoa!
Around there, we have Kraken and Take Me to the Bridge, and before that, Vanessa Rubin, Spend the Night. I wanted to bring your attention. 2 weeks ago, we had a guest, Aisha, and she is going to be celebrating her new CD called Take Me Higher. So it's going to be playing here, or she's going to have a CD release party here in the Los Angeles area. So come on out and help us celebrate her CD release party. That's this coming Friday, May 8th. At the E Spot Lounge, located at 4349 Tujunga Avenue in Studio City, California. And tickets are $25. Again, that's at the E Spot Lounge, Friday, May 8th. Aisha and her CD release party, Take Me Higher.
As we continue the show, we're going to close it out with the one last song by this. She said she wants to hear this song tonight.
Yes.
So, Miss Susaye Greene, this is for you.
Thank you.
If you need me, coming home.
feeling this in the night right here, boy.
Oh, yes.
Did I get this right? You guys wrote this about somebody coming over and just come over when I call and just come over and do work.
Yes, well,
it's called a late night snack.
It's called
a nightcap.
It's called love.
It's called love.
It's called love.
It's called love.
But there's all kinds of love.
For that moment.
And for grown people, you know, right. In the night is nighttime is the right time.
Okay. Please come out at night.
Uh-oh. Welcome, starting to feel herself.
Yeah.
Aha.
So you did that with Sherry? Did you do that?
Well, this was from the Partners album, okay. Sherry and Susaye. But that's me, of course. That's me singing the lead. And I wrote that
like
with
that.
Ed Brown, who was Minnie Riperton's bass player.
Okay.
Fantastic player. He was so bad of a bass player that Nate Watts, who was Stevie Wonder's bass player, who's one of the baddest bass players in the world, Stevie tried to hire him at the same time.
Did he?
Yes, he did.
Wow.
But you see, when you write songs that are about all the things that we all understand, you know, this song touched a lot of people. And people say it was the sexiest song on the album.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we all feel those same things.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Never and lied about that.
Universal truth.
There you go. That's what it's all about.
But you are versatile, my dear. I'm talking about versatile.
I try to be.
So
I do a lot of things, and I'm interested in a lot of things.
So you are philanthropy,
yes.
Artiste,
yes.
And even a children's book. So I'm going to go
Absolutely.
Ahead and take it away and let you do your
okay.
thing.
Okay. I have a children's book that's going to come out pretty soon called Those Cousins, which is about little girls and empowering them to be scientists, to be mathematicians, to be whatever they want to be, both in their reality and in their fantasy. Because children have a very rich fantasy life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they can think of themselves as queens of Egypt riding on Cleopatra's barge while they're sitting at the table just eating soup and bread and butter.
Okay.
Or attorney general.
There you go.
Right.
You know,
yes.
Little girls have
exactly.
to, because women, regardless of the fact that women are in the workplace now, women are still the primary carers of
mm-hmm.
children. And consequently, the philanthropy work that I do with PeaceProize.com. PeaceProize.com is where you can go. It's a site where you can sign the Goodwill Treaty for World Peace, which we designed to make the intention shown of the possibility of peace and all
wow.
the things that go along with that. You know, in a, I say less than 50 years, and these are facts you can look up yourself. And I absolutely recommend that people do some research and find out what's going on in the world, the big issues. In less than 50 years, we won't have any water, which will totally obliterate the need to fight, the need to be afraid about racism, about just all of the problems. Terrorism will mean nothing if there's not a drop of water.
Yes.
And he who holds the water rules the world. We know that right now because companies like Nestle are privatizing water and buying up all the water for bottled water.
Mm.
They own so many Arrowhead, all of the water, bottled waters company. You can best believe they have their hand in it. And they have announced that they don't believe that water is a human right. Well, 70% of the deaths of children in the world are through diarrhea from drinking contaminated water.
Mm-hmm.
So those third world countries are already suffering for the lack of water. But when it gets so that we all don't have water, it'll be a different world.
Yeah.
So PeaceProize.com is honing in on the big problems. Health, trying to re-educate women, trying to work for rehab for young women, because we all know we live in a drug culture. We all know we live in a culture of violence. But peace is a possibility that starts within each person. So you can go to Peace Prize, you can sign that treaty along with the more than 150,000 people that we've already got to sign that believe that it's possible. And the issues of waste, of all the islands of trash that are in the middle of the ocean, of health, our health, re-educating us how to eat properly, how to have high self-esteem for girls particularly, so that they are girded with the strength to fight off things like teenage pregnancy and violence in their relationships. Mm-hmm. They need to know that they can be strong, that they can be anything that they want to
and that's what
we're doing. Wow,
it's interesting you said that. I had a conversation with a friend of mine that talked about in Africa, women ruled for centuries.
That's right.
You know, it was a matriarchal society. Sure. You know, it's based on the woman. So
yes. Do you know there was a woman queen named Hatshepsut who was the queen of Egypt. And Egypt, whether people realize it or not, Egypt is only separated from Africa by the Suez Canal. Mm-hmm. Which is a man-made thing. Mm-hmm. So Egypt was part of Africa.
Africa, right.
Well, it's Northern Africa.
Yeah, it still is.
You have so much going on. Would you please give us, I think the information is up there on the website and how we get in touch with you, Twitter, and all your current projects. You have a news project that's coming out.
Yes, indeed. I have a new music project that's getting ready to come out. And I'm in a place right now where I feel my power. You know, I know that we're not given but a certain amount of years in life, and I feel that pressure to accomplish the things that I want to accomplish.
That's great.
So I'm going for it. I'm going hardcore. And I recommend everybody else to do that too.
That's right.
Go for your passion. Find something you're passionate about, and it'll make you happy the rest of your life. And I'm online. You can find me on Facebook. That's Susaye, S-U-S-A-Y-E, Greene, G-R-E-E-N-E. If you don't want to go to that one particular place, you can Google me, and you can find me. I'm there. You know,
that's right.
I'm there. I believe in being down to earth and being there for people. I was born to uplift people, and that's what I try to do with my music. With my art, I'm at deviantart.com. I'm a good artist. I love what I do, and it's the things that have kept me happy since childhood.
And you got some artwork. Some artwork that she did. Those three photos. Mm-hmm. Those was art that you did, and we'll show those. That's one you. So you painted yourself.
Yes, that's my gorgeous character. Extreme, which is one of my websites. Supreme Extreme is a character that I dreamed about.
Wow.
Who was an alien. Not really. She's sort of my 25-year-old self, who can do all the things. That's why she's extreme. She can do all the things that I have sense enough not to do.
Is beautiful.
You've had so much talent. Well, I've had a lot of blessings.
And it's a blessing for us to be able to hand you over the We Love Rare Groove gift to you.
Wow.
All your accomplishments.
Thank you.
This fits in with everything else that you have done over the years.
I will treasure that. I'll have a special spot to put that, gilded spot.
Please, thank you very much for all. And then
it's my pleasure.
Can we get a signature of an LP? You got that signature LP right there?
How lovely.
And then we're going to continue the show of, there you go, we got an actual signature. Did you have
that's
the album. So that's the album right there.
That's right.
And she's going to sign that over to Greg from We Love Rare Grooves. Or you didn't want that on it. You just wanted Greg on there.
Just sign her name.
Just sign your name to Greg.
Not even to Greg.
Oh,
just sign it. This way
I put Love Susaye.
There you go.
Watch out.
He's turning red.
And may I just say thank you to all of you. You've been very kind. It's like coming home.
It is. Yeah. That's right.
And you're welcome back anytime.
Thank you.
Hope you do come back with your new project that you have.
Yes, I'd love to. Thank you.
Anybody that you produce and are coming, we'll do it here, and we'll keep your name and the music alive here on We Love Rare Grooves. So this is another edition of Monday Nights on We Love Rare Grooves, giving you the grooves all over the globe. And we can be found on our Facebook, our YouTube page. We even have a Twitter account, if I could just remember that. Password to get in there. Oh, my God. But thank you, everyone in the listening audience around, everyone in the studios. Thank you very much for coming and supporting the project tonight. DJ DeVoe, you put it down.
Hey, brother, I appreciate it.
As you normally do. And we couldn't do it with the producer extraordinaire, Mr. Greg, New York City.
Hey.
The consultant joined us tonight.
Absolutely.
Appreciate you. Mm-hmm. And the lovely Shantanae.
Thank you.
You. And Miss Greene, thank you very much for being a part of this.
Yeah. My pleasure.
Join us next week.
It's a Greene thing.
Same groove time, same groove channel, and we're going to be funky. And, hey, they told us on Facebook we couldn't do it next week. We going deep down in the hip-hop world with Def Jeff.
Oh.
I found him.
Okay.
Ah.
Okay.
So please stay tuned to Face. So, I mean, please stay tuned to us on our Facebook page here on We
Love Rare Grooves.
Yes, we do. Yabba dabba.